Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Widgets and Wonders, my show about great products from small companies. Now today, we're going to take a look at some accessories for Warhammer Underworld Shadespire made by Red Beam Designs. These little character trays are basically designed to hold all the information you need relevant for your characters in one spot, so it doesn't get all knocked around, mixed up, and you lose track of it during gameplay. Now these handy little MDF widgets come packed in packs of 7, which of course is the maximum group size for any Shadespire team. There's only 7 deployment spots, and currently the Sepulchral Guard, I think, max out at 7. So let's take a look at them. You can see them set up with some cards and get an idea of how useful they are in a game. So here we go with the Shadespire character boards by Red Beam Designs. You can see here 3 laid out for Steelheart's champions and get the gist of how they work. They are in 2 pieces. When they come out of the box, you can see here they're just glued together. There's a top and bottom layer and they come 7 in a pack. So I've taken 2 extras out of this one to make these 8, which is enough for the core game basically. But if you want to buy them individually, 7 in a pack means that you have as many as you need for your team all the time, regardless of which team you decide to deploy, because of course the max unit size is 7. I just wood glued these down, sprayed them with some Rust-Oleum Painter's Touch chalk paints, and gave them a quick gray sponge to make them look a little bit rocky, and then I sealed them with some semi-gloss varnish, some spray varnish. And so you've got spots basically for your character cards. I like this handy little divot. I'm even doing this left-handed because I'm terrible with my left hand. To flip it over so you can show your guys inspired. You've got spots for all their upgrades or any active ploys that would go on in them so you don't forget what they are. And then of course you got this little thing down here for any status effects such as if you have charged, if you've run, if you have wounds on you, whatever. This little bank right here lets you sort of store all that information. Super handy, easy to pack up too. Like they just sit flat and 7 of them will be a little bit wider than that little bundle right there. But I'm just gonna elastic band all these 8 together. So enough for both sides in the core game. And you're ready to rock and roll. This is a handy little gizmo if you're looking to play some games and keep your side organized. So you'll see me using these in my games coming up, just to keep our characters organized on each side. And when you line them up, of course, you can easily tell who's got what, and keep all of your cards basically separated. So I did notice that I was getting cards kind of like piled on top of each other during games, and having sort of a little dashboard here of all my characters is going to be super handy. So there they are, the character boards for Shadespire from Red Beam Designs. All right, so there you go, the last Widgets and Wonders of 2017. Now, if you're interested, I will link, of course, in the video description below, the character trays for Shadespire. And if you know of a great product from a small company you think it deserves more attention, you can email me at grillminiaturegames@gmail.com or Facebook message me at facebook.com/outofthebasementintothestreets, and I'll do my best to put in front of as many people as possible. So anyway, hope you enjoyed that. Big thanks in 2017 for all of the things you guys checked out and little companies you may have basically gone and seen instead of having them be overlooked. And we'll do more of this, of course, coming up in the new year. Till next time, happy holidays, happy new year. I'm Ash. Happy wargaming. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to support the channel, of course, like and subscribe and hit the little bell below so you get notifications when I post future content. I do post stuff 7 days a week. If you want to support the channel further, you can, of course, buy a t-shirt through Spreadshirts, buy a measuring gauge or objective markers from Death Ray Designs. Or, of course, most importantly, there is Patreon. Patreon is what makes all this possible. Keeps the lights on, pays for the studio costs, pays for the equipment, model costs, and everything else. And most importantly, puts food in my kids' bellies and a roof over their heads. Big thanks to everyone past, future, who supported me. I do this stuff because of you guys, and of course, I will continue doing it as long as I can.